Tonight, the country's largest state getting ready for battle with the president-elect. Kyung Hwa's out front.
You got your text.
California's most powerful lawmaker is preparing for the looming war against Trump's agenda.
We don't want to fight. We're not looking for a fight. But if necessary, we will fight to protect the values of California.
Puebla, Oaxaca.
Well, Kevin DeLeon is fighting to protect.
You got her selling her breads, then you got this hipster selling their breads.
He sees in his Los Angeles district a far cry from Trump's America.
I'm really confused when he talks about let's make America great again. Every time we go back to the 50s.
California refuses to turn back the clock, says DeLeon.
Given what I've seen so far with regards to the cabinet selections, there probably is going to be a fight around the corner very, very soon.
Are you up for the fight?
Of course we're up to the fight.
Are you up for the fight?
Yeah, I'm up for the fight, there's no doubt.
DeLeon leveraging the power of America's largest state against Trump. California is 13% of the U.S. economy, with the GDP bigger than Brazil. While Trump won the country, California, 40% Latino, went more left, voting in a supermajority of Democrats to the state house, growing more progressive on issues like the environment, minimum wage, gay rights, and immigration.
We will not let you down by backing down.
Opening his final term as Senate leader, DeLeon led the charge on state bills protecting undocumented immigrants, sending a message to Washington.
We can't prohibit them from doing what they want to do, if in fact they want to move forward with massive deportations, but we surely don't have to help them.
We block the funding, no more funding.
Trump has pledged to take away federal funding from so-called sanctuary cities that protect undocumented immigrants.
Cities that refuse to cooperate with federal authorities will not receive taxpayer dollars.
With all major California cities declaring themselves sanctuaries, DeLeon knows hundreds of millions of dollars are on the table.
It's my hope that there won't be political retribution.
They are creating a hysteria in our state.
Robin Vidson, head of a conservative grassroots group in California, says state lawmakers are ignoring the 4 million Californians who voted for Trump.
We should be a state that upholds and respects the law. That's what our lawmakers should be focused upon in Sacramento.
The Senate leader says this is about more than California. It's about setting an alternate agenda, protecting the other Americans who did not vote for Trump.
They can look towards California either way.
In the battle with Trump?
In the battle for the values that we hold dearly. So the answer is yes.
DeLeon has a unique perspective on immigration. His mother was an undocumented immigrant, a single mother struggling to raise three kids on her own. It is that upbringing that DeLeon says informs him as a lawmaker. And it's not Poppy just DeLeon, who's a powerful politician here in California. It's the head of the assembly here, as well as the incoming Attorney General Javier Becerra, who are also Latino. Poppy?
Kyung Hwa, thank you so much.